What happens at closing? Michelleoddo here with the Oddo Group at Leader One Financial, and I'll tell you what happens at a loan closing. What should you expect? Well, it depends on if it's a purchase or a refinance. Those are slightly different. Let's talk purchase. So now you made your offer, they accepted your offer, you're under contract, you go through the whole process, and now it's the day you've been waiting for. It's closing day, yay, and you're gonna get your keys, hopefully, to your new home. So what needs to happen? Well, most likely you need to bring money to closing because probably you are doing a loan for a portion, but you have a down payment and closing costs, and so money needs to be brought to closing. So your lender should have given you a cash to close number with instructions on whether you can wire the funds or you need to bring a cashier's check. You can never bring cash to a closing. You can never write a personal check at a closing. It needs to be certified funds. So it can be a wire, it can be a cashier's check. And your lender will let you know what the title company is requiring. So the title company, think of them like Switzerland, they're the neutral party where everybody comes together, they take in all the monies. So the money you bring to closing, the money the lender wires to closing, everybody's money goes to title. And then they are neutral party. They then pay off the existing mortgage on that home from the seller that's selling you the property. They pay the insurance company for the premium. They pay the title fees. They pay the recording fees. So they pay everybody involved in that transaction. And the way that they do that is by balancing monies. So our money goes to them, your money comes to them, it all goes into the account. They account for everything that needs to be paid, and then they go ahead and disperse all those funds out to the appropriate parties, and you get your keys. You will need to get your hand exercised and in good shape because you're going to be signing a lot of documents. It can be anywhere from 50 to 100 plus documents, just depending on the loan type. And you have all of your real estate documents, so putting you into title on that home. You know, the deed of trust and the note are part of the mortgage, but you're also going to sign a bunch of actual real estate documents that the title company will have for you to transfer title over to you from the sellers. So closing day can be very exciting. Hopefully everything went smooth on your loan with the lender that you worked with. I know with us, we always try to get you numbers in advance, plenty of time to review your figures. We wire our money a day in advance so you're not stressed out the day of closing. And so now you've shown up, you sign all your closing documents, you hand over that check or what maybe you've wired your funds, and you get your keys to your home. And this is all based on what's called wet funding. So Colorado is a wet funding state. The day you sign your papers is the funding day and you get your money that day, or excuse me, you get your keys that day. They get the money, the sellers get their money that day. Some states like California or Arizona are what we call an escrow state, and they don't necessarily get their keys and fund on the day of closing. It's a little bit different. But here in Colorado, we are a wet state, and that's how it works. If it's a refinance, you will do almost everything I just said, except for you will sign your papers. Usually on a refinance, you're not coming with money. You might be, but usually you're either getting money back or the loan, the closing costs are rolled into your loan. So regardless, you're going to show up at closing, you're going to sign your paperwork, and if it's an owner-occupied refinance, there's what's called a three-day right of rescission. So you will wait 3 days. If you close, for example, on a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, midnight Thursday is your last day to rescind if this is not a loan that you want. And then it funds on Friday, meaning they pay off your existing mortgage lender. If you're getting cash back, that money would come to you on Friday, that, you know, after that 3 day waiting period. But everything else is the same. You're still going to sign a bunch of papers and you should have what's called a closing disclosure that has all of your figures on it for you. So you know who you're paying off, your mortgages, if you're paying off any debt, what your rate is, what your payment is, what your new loan amount is, and if you're getting cash back, what that looks like. So the Oddo Group here, what we try to do is always get your loan done with some time for you to review your figures before closing. We like to walk through those figures with you. Usually if it's a purchase, your realtor will be at that closing, maybe your lender, and sometimes the seller will be at the closing. But for sure you'll be there and probably your realtor and the title closer. So if you have any questions, we'd love to walk you through the process. Michelleoddo here with the Oddo Group at Leader One Financial. And we're always trying to just make that process smooth and always let you know the next steps so you're not wondering what is going on. Give us a call.